a graduate student in physics, and I'm so excited to tell you about my research in null Lagrangians. So before we talk about null Lagrangians, we need to talk about forces. Over 300 years ago, Isaac Newton introduced force by adding it to a system. I'm excited to tell you about my method today, where we use null Lagrangians to allow force to arise more intrinsically from the physical system, which is a different way to think about force overall. So when we're looking at a physical system, we first look at either forces or energy to try to characterize the system. So Lagrangians are a powerful tool we use in physics to do this. We can use a Lagrangian to characterize a system and to account for the different objects in the system itself. So when we're looking at a Lagrangian, typically we feed it through something called an Euler-Lagrange equation, as I've shown here, and it gives us the equation of motion, which, as you might have guessed, describes the motion of the system. So right now we need new tools to think about physics because much of our universe is still not yet understood. Only roughly 5% of the universe is made of visible matter, which is the matter that we're used to talking about. We still have much more of the universe which is comprised of dark energy and dark matter. So we're looking for new tools and different ways to examine our universe to try to understand other physical phenomena that we haven't yet been able to understand or explore. I think null Lagrangians are the perfect candidate for this type of research because we haven't yet really explored them in physics, but as I hope to convince you, they've already led to some really exciting results just in a little bit of exploration over the last few years. So null Lagrangians are a special family of Lagrangians, and they've shown us a new way to think about forces. So a null Lagrangian, we can feed through the Euler-Lagrange equation, just like a standard Lagrangian. But when you do that, you get zero. Instead of giving you an interesting equation of motion with some different variables, the Euler-Lagrange applied to a null Lagrangian just gives you a result of zero. So for a long time, we thought they weren't that interesting in physics, and mathematicians explored null Lagrangians, but we thought, well, if they just give us zero, why would we care? So what I found is that actually, if you use the energy function, which is often used alongside the Euler-Lagrange equation, and you feed a null Lagrangian through the energy function, you end up with this additional term. It doesn't go to zero. You get a result from it. So what you can also do is add a null Lagrangian to a standard Lagrangian for any sort of physical system, and then feed this through the same formalism and apply the energy function to this, and you still end up with this new term from the null Lagrangian. So what is that term? We asked this question and we investigated the resulting term from the energy function that you get for the null Lagrangian, which seemed to be unimportant before, but is now arising. It turns out that that term is of the form of a force. So this is such an interesting new way to think about forces. So we started applying this to other forces in physics to say, okay, well, how many forces will it work for? It works for all sorts of forces in physics, and we're finding so many interesting results where you can describe a force from even engineering or other areas by using this approach. And starting with a null Lagrangian, you can get these forces that we've been using all along. So then I also started asking, well, how many of these are possible? How many null Lagrangians can you make that could possibly result in these force terms? And I found that you can make an infinite number of null Lagrangians. And I developed a formalism for doing this and a formalism for finding the resulting force terms, if they exist, from the null Lagrangians. This gives us a context for any force terms that we find or any other sort of terms that result from the null Lagrangian. So then I asked, well, okay, but can you look at nonlinear terms? Can you look at anything else using null Lagrangians? And right now we're finding that you may be able to describe nonlinear terms also using null Lagrangians in the same way, allowing them to arise from the null Lagrangian. This is a completely different way to look at forces, and it allows for us to introduce a force to a system in this much more intrinsic manner, allowing it to arise from a null Lagrangian rather than just adding it on. So I think that this is a wonderful tool, and I think that there's so much promise in the area of null Lagrangians, and I really appreciate you coming along with me today.